In this video, I'm going to share with you three eye health tips that I try to share with every single one of my patients in the eye clinic. Because with these tips, hopefully you can keep your eyes seeing better and feeling better longer. Let's take a look. Hey, what's up? This is Dr. Alan here from the Dr. Eye Health Show, helping you learn all about the eyes, vision, and finding the best vision products. Now, today we're going to be talking about just three simple, easy eye health tips that I like to talk about and share with every patient that comes in to see me for a routine eye examination. These are just three tips that you can incorporate into your lifestyle, and hopefully they can keep your eyes seeing better and feeling better. The first tip is, of course, eating more fruits and vegetables. A huge part of eye health is the fact that the retina in the back of the eye that gives you your eyesight is one of the most highly metabolic tissues in your entire body. And that means that nutrition plays a huge role in how that retina is able to function. Now, I do hope to have more detailed videos going over nutrition and which specific vitamins and minerals work the best for parts of the eye and different eye diseases. But the easiest thing that I tell with most patients is to eat more green leafy vegetables. And I'm not just talking about iceberg lettuce, I mean the dark leafy greens. I mean spinach, kale, arugula, just anything with the bitter with the dirt taste, it seems like. Now, I know everybody thinks that carrots is like the superfood for the eyes, but in fact, recent science has shown that green leafy vegetables is better because of something called lutein. Lutein is an antioxidant that's found in very high concentrations in the center part of the back of the eyeball called the macula, which is the center part of your vision that gives you things like your sharp reading ability, your color perception, all of that. And not only is lutein one of the key ingredients in most eye vitamin supplements for diseases like macular degeneration, but has even been found now to be helpful in patients who have diabetic retinopathy. And overall, having higher amounts of lutein is correlated with a higher amount of macular pigment optical density, or just higher amounts of protective pigment in the back of the eye from high oxidative stress, from sunlight exposure and things like that. So again, eat your leafy greens, and don't worry, if you're not a salad person like myself, I personally don't like to eat salad. Instead, just make a green smoothie or a shake or something like that. There's a lot of great recipes for these things, and yes, I try to drink or eat these as often as I can. Yum. Now, there are also vision and eye supplements that contain lutein, and some people may choose to go that route. I do hope to have an entire video series going more in depth discussing the science of eye vitamins, so stay tuned for that one. I personally think it's better to try to eat healthy foods and incorporate that into your lifestyle because it's going to help fuel your whole body rather than rely on supplements. But at least if you want to know more about lutein specifically, I'll put at least some links below the like button to specific studies that give a really good review of lutein and benefits for the eye. Now, outside of eating really healthy, a common thing that many eye doctors will tell you is to wear sunglasses when you're outside. And I don't just say sunglasses, but also wide brim hats and anything just to add some UV light protection to your eyes as well as your eyelids, because UV light from the sun over the course of your lifetime can contribute to development of different eye diseases. Things like cataracts, pterygium and pinguecula, which we've done videos on. Also thinning and aging of your eyelids, which can contribute to dark circles and eye bags. Again, all topics that we have covered on this channel. And you certainly don't have to reach for high-end expensive sunglasses. There's many affordable brands of sunwear out there that offer 100% UV light protection. Just make sure that you look on the sides of your sunglasses and that you're looking for something that says 100% UV or maybe 400 UV. And that's because 400 nanometers is kind of the cutoff of where UV light ends and then your normal eyesight kind of begins. Now, the third tip that I talk with my patients about is cleaning their eyelashes and eyelids on a daily basis. And that's because your eyelashes are meant to do what? To block out dust, sweat, and oils from dripping into your eyes. Kind of like that brush on the bottom of a vacuum, you know how it spins and picks up stuff and eventually gets clogged up, nasty hairs and whatnot. Your eyelashes end up kind of looking like that under a microscope. And unfortunately, if it's not tended to on a regular basis, your eyelids can become red and inflamed, something we call blepharitis, which can be a significant contributing factor for redness, irritation, dry eye, lots of other issues with ocular surface disease. Now, there's many different options out there for cleaning the eyelids and eyelashes. I'll refer to other videos that I'll put again below the like button in the video description. No matter which way of cleaning the lashes you find is best for you, it's still just good to be doing it on a regular basis so that you're cleaning all that gunk away. Now, of course, and as always, these are three things that I typically just try to talk with most of my patients about. Some people come in with serious eye conditions. We have to kind of focus on taking care of those things first. But I think overall, if people are to adapt these kind of three tips, just start eating healthier, taking care of their eyes, protecting them, cleaning things out, their eyes are gonna feel better and you're gonna likely have better vision and at least have healthier eyes going forward. And hey, let me know in the comment section which one of these tips you found the most helpful, and make sure you're subscribed so that you don't miss my future videos about diets and supplements, all that cool stuff. Otherwise, I hope this video helped you out. Again, Dr. Alan here from the Dr. Eye Health Show. Keep an eye on it. We'll talk to you soon.